Welcome to Transformation Hour with Bishop Samuel Noy Mensah, President of Full Gospel Church International, FGCI Ghana. Full Gospel Church is a Bible-believing church that's committed to helping people discover, develop, and use their gifts, talents, and abilities to enable them become useful and relevant to society, their communities, and to fulfill their life's mission on earth. At FGCI, we achieve this by helping people discover purpose to live for, people to share fellowship with, profession to live out, principles to live by, and power to live on.
Until you have a dream, no one will attack you. Until you know where you are going, no one will fight you.
We believe that anointed and pragmatic teaching is the catalyst for transformation in the lives of individuals and in the church. Hence our message, transforming lives on purpose.
Some complain about the problem. Others will find people to blame about the problem. Only few, the 20%, will fix the problem they encounter.
Full Gospel Church International is a place where we help people reconnect to God. Leaders are raised to be change agents, and talents and gifts are discovered and used.
No matter where you stand, somebody will tag you, but stand for Ghana.
At FGCI, we believe that every member is a minister and that we are saved to save others.
What will connect you to an auto mechanic? It's only when you have a problem with your vehicle. That is when you now look for an auto mechanic. So you see, problems bring people together in bad times.
We invite you to be our regular guest this and every Sunday on this network as we bring you a systematic and expository teaching of God's Word with Bishop Samuel Noy Mensah.
Don't look at things only from your own perspective. So learn to see things from somebody else's perspective. That is the only way you can appreciate the contributions. I'm speaking on the subject, raising responsible children. Some time ago in 2017, the Joy News carried a story captioned, "Crack the Whip and Save the Country's Future." And they said, according to statistics conducted by the Ghana Health Service, about 750,000 teenagers between the ages of 15 to 19 became pregnant in 2016.
2016 no mebu a obwe di beye infie dunum ekosi dun watwe ho no omo nyina omo be fa emprewanyinsin
750,000 teenagers from 15 to 19 years were pregnant in 1 year.
Na afi ba ko no emofra bebre efi infie dunum ekosi dun kro no emprewanyinsin.
Out of this number, 14,000 teenagers were from Central Region.
Nah, 14,000. No, I'm all free. Free man.
So those of you from Central Region, take note.
Nah, I'm all free. Free man. Temu no one shining so.
14,000 from Central Region. Muya di.
14,000. Muya di.
Musisi muya mude. But wait a minute. 10,000 from Greater Accra.
Now 10,000 is so every Greater Accra.
What they know is Pojiemo. Teenagers. Interestingly, at the recent health review for Greater Accra, it came to light that not only teenagers are now getting pregnant, but young girls from 10 to 14 years are equally getting pregnant.
And
these 10-year girls are sleeping with men and they are getting pregnant.
They
said, what is the question? What is the future of a community or even a country where girls are dropping out of school at the age of 10 during pregnancy, due to pregnancy?
Na you answer no den yen dachi sa emofrano and sign and priwanyen sent to mun to me school.
The article asks, have we lost it as parents and as community leaders?
Na aso awofuano yana ya modern bo enso eni anase empenyimfuano.
He said the time is due for us as a society to start cracking the whip. And very hard one on child delinquency and parent neglect.
Now, say ya bomo dia ni a sorry waka. Na say ye awufu aye jaye mano. Ye bomo dia ni maye ni enkwaye mane so.
On January 9th, 2014, Joy News also carried a story that Dompasi, I believe I've mentioned it right there. Eh? Dompuasi. All right. Okay. Where is it? Ashanti region. All right. So they said Dompuasi SHS students, senior prefect arrested for armed robbery.
Nah, Dompuasi school, secondary school, no, or prefect penyino ya cheno, say all ya conforem for.
A student and a school prefect in the night goes on armed robbery activities.
School prefects and Ajono na onu we peer or kwa chrono.
And this was carried 2014 by Joy News, and it said that the police in Kumasi have arrested three suspected armed robbers for various crimes committed in Ashanti region. They include 21-year-old Nicholas Japon alias Sparklos of Dompuasi Senior High School and two other unemployed aged 26 and 32. The senior prefect of the school, and they mention his name, also known as Shaka, is alleged to be the leader of the gang.
Na ewo Kumasi nso no apostle echia konforiam fo miensa na sa senior prefect e friend Nicholas no ono nso kan na akronforiam fo no ono no di omutintima ono no ye penyin.
A student, school prefect, an armed robber.
Oye suku ni o eno senior prefect a osanye konforiam fo.
2020 2nd July, the Joy News carried another story. 18 students of Solpon Methodist SHS debodenized. In other words, they have thrown them out of the school and they should become day students.
Na afi etwe mu e wo Solpon so no school mo fra do ngwetwe no ye yo mo afi school o se se ano omo fifie na omo mbre school.
The article said 18 students of Solpon Methodist Senior High School have been debodenized for organizing demonstrations against the school authorities. And they said the students demonstrated because they said they were not provided with ironing facilities, and they charged on the authorities, and the authorities denied that. Now, they destroyed louver blades and some other items in their dormitory and attempted to assault senior house master and other workers in the school.
Almost say near my baby brother, ya mom near my eye, that two are the end to do. Almost say near my eye, open ya or that's a good anumpo. Almost your mother's uncle, more quack or bono.
Now listen, the very Reverend Pa Solomon Grant Eslifi, the headmaster of the school, announces at the PTA meeting on the school premise on a Thursday. He cautioned parents and guidance against defending their walls when they commit crimes in school, since students exhibit different character in the school from what they show in the home.
Na osofo na oda omo anono emra ye fre pti eno obo awofo ne kokose se ye mofra no eya mfomso a ye ndan se ye beka se me bade ontisa esanse se mofra ne wo suku a omo suma ye nsonko edanso omo befie nso a omo suma edanso.
Don't vouch for your children and don't believe everything they tell you. What the headmaster is saying that in their home they appear like angels, but when they get to the school, they have a different character altogether.
Na headmaster ne patcho se e wo fie no ye mofra ne yo mo de te se de omo ye osoro abofo na omo besuku nso omo suman no edanso.
He cautioned parents and teachers to be on their guard against the practice of homosexuality and lesbianism by their children, as reports from school indicate that some students indulge in this canker.
Na obo awofo ni atrechrefo no kokose omo ma omo ni nda ho emfa emofra ne wo esan se emema ni emema no mutime fefa omo ho na ema ni ma no so timi ye lesbobo eno nti no omo nya ahweyie ewo emofra ne ho.
Just this last July, the 4th of July 2021, this year, the same Joy News carried a story, Adenta police sensitized students on drug abuse.
Now I feel we are July, we are no Adenta police of one else more and more fra.
They said Superintendent Al-Hassan bemoaned a worrying trend of students being arrested as part of a recent police-led swoops and raid of ghettos within the Adenta district. And this has to do with drugs, cocaine, and all kinds of evil practices.
Adenta no police for no to say for get to a hurrah baby and omokochi and crawford baby and omonum in Rubone.
From the above news outlet, it is certain that parents have responsibilities to their children. We have a responsibility that we must raise the children in the way they should go. No wonder King Solomon admonishes us to train up the children in the way they should go. I'm speaking on the subject raising responsible children. Now my scripture text is Proverbs chapter 22:1-6. Can you rise with me as I read the word of the Lord, please? This is a word from one of the wisest men who ever lived on planet Earth. Trainings the father gave to him, he put all together and called it Proverbs. Whilst he was growing up, all the lessons he learned in life, he put them together and advise the next generation.
Emra onyi no efutun sam a onyaye no oboa ni nyinara no eno onto awonto atoaso ofo.
And it was called Proverbs.
Na eno ne yetu ni din se mebusem.
So Proverbs is as a result of what Solomon learned in life.
Mebusem no ye niamo hine Solomon sua ewa abrabo mu.
Under his parents.
Ewa emra na wofo osha omo asem.
And in chapter 22, this is what he said.
Eti eduenu mienu no wene nia okaye.
A good name is to be chosen rather than great riches, loving favor rather than silver and gold. The rich and the poor have this in common: the Lord is the maker of them all. A prudent man foresees evil and hides himself, but the simple pass on and are punished. Verse 4. But humility and the fear of the Lord are riches and honor and life. Thorns and snares are in the way of the perverse. He who guards his soul will be far from them. And verse 6, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he or she is old, will not depart from it. Congregation, help me to read verse 6 together. Let's go. Amen. Please be seated. What should be some of the things we should consider in the training of our children? What I'm about to share with you was an article I received on one of the, my wife either shared it with me, and I saw it some weeks ago. I said, this is good. And I took note of that. And so I'm not the original author of this, but this person outlined some things that parents must consider to do, and I have adopted it and situated it in this particular scripture and on this day to share with you. So what parents must do? Number one, introduce your children to know God personally. Salvation is not hereditary. Salvation is an individual affair. Be sure that your children know Jesus as their Lord and personal Savior. The fact that you are born again, the fact that you are a pastor, the fact that you are a deacon, the fact that you are a great mature believer is not a guarantee that your children are the same. The fact that you believe in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior does not suggest your children also believe in Jesus as Lord and Savior. You need to meet with your children and ask them who they believe in. You need to be sure that they believe in the God you are serving. Salvation cannot be bequeathed. Salvation cannot be inherited. Salvation is on individual basis. God do not have grandchildren. God has children. The Father is a child of God. The Son of the Father is a child of God. The great grandson of the Father is a child of God. When the Father stands before God, he says, "Our Father." When my son is praying, he will say, "Our Father." When his children are praying, they will say, "Our Father." We are all sons and daughters of the living God. You must be conscious and deliberately lead them to God. Have devotions with them. Have a family devotion, a family time of prayer, and a family communion with the children. Number two, assign the children with domestic tax according to their age group. Give your children age appropriate domestic tax, even if you have numerous domestic servants in the house. Let your children learn to do things also by themselves in the house. Doing everything for your children is not a mark of honor or a mark of raising a royal child, you are rather destroying the child.
How
can you can have numerous servants in the house, but why would you allow your children, when they eat, they should put the plates in the sink and for your domestic servants to wash them? They must wash their own plates. They must serve their own breakfast. Do not allow domestic servants to come and serve them on the dining table. They must go to the kitchen, fix their food, serve themselves, clean the mess, and then wash the plate by themselves.
Na sa owo osunfo bebre a omo bua wo fiempo a eno nkyra sa sa wo medidi a no mo de pine na anase nkukuo na kobo a no na omo bua wo fie no mo abetwitwi mo da bi o enyo mo na sa anopa anase ewia enwumre omo de aduane be sepon so ma wo ma da bi ma wo ma ne ewu se nia yeye ti yeye koko yeye biribia se de be ya se komo de omo a omo nka so mo be komo kan se akwakonua edi.
When they grow up and they can afford domestic servants, then they can employ domestic servants to do something for them. But whilst you are paying for those services, force them to learn to do things by themselves too. You will then be building a responsible citizen and a responsible children.
So amusu omunyi na omuye ejuba jisike gu omuboto mu a ometimi afankro fo na omasum omu na empredodo omusha wasi awu na utua nyuma yefo ne ka no momu ankasa omunye bibi omunu obadua na omuntiti nkuku omu wo yesa na wo tete dachi emofra papa.
Number 3, teach the children to be useful and make their impact felt positively wherever they are in life.
Ma wo mafra ni hu somu wo mfaso se de be ya bebe biara omo be du omo be ko wo abrabo mu no ye be hu omo so mfaso.
In the school, let people feel their presence. In the church, let people feel their presence. Wherever they are at the home, that you can be proud of them. Teach them that they can be dignified children.
Natural mo se empo ewo asori ewo suku bebi biara omo be ko no a enkrofo bebi sase wan be die eno nti ewo fie bebi biara omo be du no mo mo se omo ye enkole bi omo so bo.
Number 4, teach your children to always leave a good impression wherever they go.
Na dia to so no tra wo ma se bebi biara a omo be ko no omo be ja ahyenso die pa ewo ho.
Teach them to be courteous, to learn how to be nice to people and speak nicely. To allow and sit down as a mother and a father and hear your child insulting the junior brother or the senior brother or insulting an elderly person in your presence is a number one error.
Na sa wo bet na se se awofo na wa hwa wo bucket so na oyeje ne nua panyi a eyemfom so pa.
You don't have to sit and watch a child of yours insulting the junior brother or the senior brother or an elderly person in your presence and you are happy.
And sasa what's an asu? Naya and Shanghai, Sawa Bofrakitswa, Eddie didn't nua panyi at sem na we near Jena was re.
Teach them to be courteous. Teach them to be respectful. Teach them to be friendly. Teach them to be cheerful. Teach them to be helpful. Teach them to be diligent and to work hard.
Trauma said, baby, be a rum of a corner. I'm on your in see your. I'm on to me get into my day. I'm on to omuni. Baby, be a rum of a corner. I'm on don't nipa.
Teach them how to smile.
Trauma senya yes, sir.
Some of you have so strong a face you don't even smile. So because of that, you pass on to your children like that. Teach them to watch and look at themselves in the mirror and begin the practice of smiling.
Number 5.
Teach them good toilet manners.
Niatosu numno trawo mofrano somo ko ejana bia senia yesiesi ho.
Teach them good toilet manners. What that means is that they must know how to keep the toilet neat for the next user. Teach them that they should not leave the toilet room without making sure that everything has been flushed. Teach the boys that when they are going to pee, they need to lift the toilet seat up so that they can get close to the toilet seat, the toilet bowl, and pee in. They shouldn't stand at a distance and then they throw the water in and then they soil the entire ground, and when they leave, the place is in a mess. Teach your boys how to maintain good toilet manners. Those of you now clapping, you are a suspect. I can predict what is in your homes.
I read of a managing director,
very wealthy guy, managing director, well to do, have children, but you know, he doesn't know how to flush a toilet. Anytime he uses the WC, he leaves it the way it is.
Managing director, Mwa, na no do bedjebo. On them Sanya Jana, be all we are now the Unsa Piana Tikwanona in Sunday, the Ninyanako, or we are Panuwe Jahoko.
Because when he was growing up, he grew up in an environment of the KIVP, the, what do you call it? KV. The KVIP, you know, that way there's nothing like you flash. You finish, you do your thing, you go. So he's grown up, and even when they introduce, you know, the toilet flushing thing, he hasn't adopted the practice of learning. Now a managing director, moi, he goes to the W, does his own thing, and he leaves it. And somebody has to flush this thing for him. So teach your children toilet manners. Let them know it is unacceptable to use the bathroom and leave the soapy water on the floor, the soapy water on the wall, the soap, the foams on the wall. Tell them it's unacceptable. When they finish bathing, they should wash the soapy water around. If the ground is wet, they should mop it properly. There shouldn't be soapy foams all around dotted on the wall. Teach them these manners. I'm teaching good, though. And I know you, some of you are also learning now.
Number 6,
teach your children the importance of good hygiene and their surroundings. Importance of good hygiene. What that means is that whether they are at home or elsewhere, remind them that they are responsible people and they don't have to leave their room unkept. They should never get out of bed without dressing their bed. Teach them when they get up, it is their responsibility to dress their bed. Make sure, as a mother and a father, you will enforce this rule. You gather from your bed, you fold your cloth, you arrange your pillow well, and you lay your bed and you dress it. At least, when Jesus rose from the dead, he folded his grave clothes, packed them properly. And when the angels came to the tomb, they saw the grave clothes well folded. What are we talking about? What are we talking about? He folded his grave clothes, well organized and well decent. And when the angels themselves came, the scripture said they saw the grave clothes well folded.
In your fitana ya de katane wono obobone kama kama ediguo eno ti emra abofo ne baye no omo hu se enyura no ya obobone kama kama eno ti wo ma no sori ayenchire omo se wo sori a entoma udi akata ho wo mpa no siesie so na muamua entoma no na bubo ni nyina rafeguo.
Teach them how to bathe well and smell nicely. It is unpleasant to have a young boy or a young girl with a body bad odor. It is not good.
And yes, sir, Uba Baiwa, and as I be more, Oba Tao, Honona, Mochiona, and Pampa be one, and yet.
Let them take care of their armpits. Let them take care of their teeth and their hair. Sometimes when we are having youth programs and what have you, and these guys are dancing and the girls and the boys are dancing, you need to use the nose marks. You know, because the air and the scent, you need to use some nose. It's something else. Are you hearing me? Hey, are you hearing me?
Number 7,
teach your children to manage their dirty clothes and other personal belongings well.
They
should not leave their dirty clothes or shoes anywhere in the house. Tell them it's not acceptable. There should be a place where dirty clothes are put there. And when you close from school or from work, you should arrange your shoes well.
One
shoe cannot be in the kitchen, one other shoe on the compound, and everything is scattered. If they grow like that, they will become a problem in the marriage. Everything should be well organized and well structured. Even me in my wardrobe, dresses are arranged according to color code. What that means is that if I'm looking for dresses that are about light blues, what have you, it is easy for me. So that I wouldn't look for a blue in the midst of a black one, a black one in the midst of a red one, a yellow one in the midst of a white one. All shades of white are in one area. All shades of blue are in another area. All shades of red, whatever it is, it becomes very easy for you to walk to which area you want to pick whatever. And when I finish, I make sure I put it in the according to the dress color code.
Na enye se uba be hwehwe atari fita. Afi na akwa ko tu bebi anyame tuntum da bi o. Se fita e wa ha, se kokko e wa ha, kala bia wa ha, enu ti sa be hwehwe ade tuntum a. Enye afi na me kwa ko tutu nyame fita ahwehwe ade tuntum. Me wie nso anama se ahwehwe ne kama kama kama.
You don't need to have a big place to do these things. Even in a small environment, you can rearrange them neatly. It becomes very easy when you are looking for whatever you are looking for. Number 8, teach them that in their travels, when they travel, they should learn to pack their toiletries before they leave home. That means they should not go to their host and then they say, I forgot toothpaste, I forgot Pepsodent, I forgot toothbrush, I forgot brush, I forgot cream. And your host now have to find all these things and give them to you. And sometimes, I forgot my boxer pant, or I forgot my undies and what have you. Let them learn how to pack everything.
Say a tray and more friend is a sober to choir. The kind of she shall near my wound, who brush, who wife will be our bodies, who draws, she shall in Yanara, and Yafia went to choir. Wakwa Kosia Obino, not the catcher say, oh, Madame, if you may ban me do Dorant, my father, my make a crab, oh, Madame Pacho, may ban me to bra, oh, Madame, may ban and I'm a pentameter, my body, same draws, major, so will be over to me, Mammy Debbie, to the almost send ya to be beer, I will not find so.
Number 9, teach your children to dress appropriately in all the time, especially when they are spending time with another family. Teach them how to dress appropriately. What that means is that if you allow your daughters to dress in a mini skirt, very tight, short in the house, and your sons walk bare chest in the home, they become unconscious and they carry that behavior outside. When I was growing up under my father's tutelage and growing up, we weren't taught how to walk in the house bare chest. And therefore, you could not just walk on the compound without a top on. So I've grew up with that level of training, and therefore in my house, you dare not dress or be in the house on the compound with your bare chest. You can't sit in the hall without a top on. You can't do that.
Mesa entity enumidi and you and once a woman fieno once a me you are cuckoo and bets now horse and woosh TV once a minute now I want it. I won't shut area.
In your room, you can go without your top, but the moment you get out of your bedroom, you must put something on.
I want what diamond, what makes me the wakuku and Nancy or Nancy was sorry now upiepa and so shut area.
You can't sit by the dining table, eat a breakfast or lunch without a top on, bare chest. You can't do that.
Once me and bet not dining table, what would it be? One shot at a dear.
Teach your children how to appear and present themselves well at home and outside. If we all do that as responsible parents, we will raise responsible children. And we will not only raise responsible children, we will raise responsible politicians. We will not only raise responsible politicians, we will raise responsible government. We will not only raise responsible government, but we will raise a responsible, we'll become a responsible nation.
Na say it's immediate ya massa, ye benya on mine pa any a mine pa any mrashe bedwa for pa.
Are you hearing me? I'm not feeling you. Let the ladies know they cannot walk in the house with only a bra on top. Number 10, teach them good table manners. I will continue it perhaps next week or whatever, but teach them good table manners. Teach them to chew with their mouth closed when they are eating. And
na omo didia tromo say ye didia ya kata ya no enya fi na be bia wanu up and down no bia ehu mini mu aduane a wo resa no.
Teach them to know that when they are eating and the mouth is full, you don't talk.
Na tromo ban so say wo didi na aduane she wenum na wenum aye ma ye nkasa.
No one wants to see your mouth open and talking with the food inside. It puts other people off. Teach them how to use the cutlery well, so that when they are using the cutlery, they are not biting the cutlery, and you hear the cutlery noise with their teeth at the same time.
Tromo senior, you need a training fork in a way, did he? Senior Bayer, almost you tried your animal plate. And Koya said, I think I would do. Now, somebody sick and in shop when you move, and you have no barber, real mabekika.
Remember, your children are going to be doctors, lawyers, engineers, politicians, great men and great women. Imagine they have gone to international conference, meeting a president or meeting, you know, a senior medical doctor, and they are eating. I mean, you can imagine. I mean, if he's going to represent Ghana and this is how he behaves, you can imagine the embarrassment. And when they trace his beginnings, they'll realize that that is how you raise them.
Nah, yeah, show, yeah, man, omo be yen penyin fo. Omo ko sia aman penyin o. Na omo ko na ya topo amo omo se bo medidi a. Afi na won ko wa bai we nu be shampo no bi adwane eja. Na ya hwehwe na ya hwehwe na ase a. Ye be o se a ne ma me ne ne papa sa no ye tete wo mo.
Teach them that around the table when they are eating, food particles should not scatter on the dining table. Teach them that when they are around the dining table, you don't get up and stretch your hands to pick the next food when other people are sitting next to you. You don't get up and stretch your hands and look for whatever you are picking. Tell them that the proper table manners is that you will ask the next person to pass that bowl of food to you. You don't get up and stretch your hands when you are on the dining by the dining table. Teach them that when they finish eating and you are with group of friends, you don't get out and move on the out of the table when the other colleagues have never finished eating. That is bad table manners. If you have to go, ask permission. You just don't finish eating and bam, you leave the rest of the four people. If you have to go, ask permission. Teach them.
Yet try a master, say ye dosu na ye didi, na se biana wwe didi ye we bi anyasa. Won sorry pre kope enko de bi en ja en crofon nino. Na so pesa obe kompua. E sa wusra kwa katsu muse oh me pesa me mami wonso kakra.
Number 11, teach them to learn how to wash their own plates after they have finished eating. Let me probably run quickly with you so that I wouldn't have time to finish. Number 12, teach the children not to jump into a conversation that they have never been invited to join. Teach them that. Number 13, teach the children to relate well with people around them and learn to build relationship with people and not to spend all their time on social media. Teach them not to spend all their time in their bedroom alone by themselves. They should talk to people in the house. Teach Number 14, teach them about the family values. Values guide us. Values are compass that will direct us. Value, family values helps us make decisions in life. So when we talk of values, after teaching you this, I'm going to sit down and we all have values. We have probably not reaching them, but we need now to go back home, sit down and ask ourselves, what is our family values? For example, values of respect for the elderly.
We
are talking of values of kindness, compassion, values of integrity, responsibility, being honest, being flexible, fairness, you know, giving and helping people. These are values, and values of helping people when they are in trouble. These are family values. So when you go home today, I'm giving you a homework. Sit down, husband and wife, and ask yourself, what are our family values? The Bible says something in Hebrews chapter 11, around verse 3 and 4, he said, by faith, Abel offered a more glorious and acceptable sacrifice. Give me Hebrews quickly. Hebrews chapter 11.
Hebrew for my exidu, Baku Yumumi and some Bible say, I will Jidia Mono Ebo, Eddie, and I say, I chat you.
Let's move on to 2 and 3. Now, by faith, when understand that the world was framed and so that things that are seen, let's move on. By faith, Abel offered to God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, through which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gift, and through it, he being dead, still speaks. His sacrifice was accepted, that those he was dead, still, though he being dead, still speaks. Though he being dead, what is it? Still, he's dead, but his legacy is speaking. He's dead, his values have been carried on. He's dead, what he believed in is being practiced. He is dead, yet the values of integrity, respect, honor, integrity, discipline, hard work is carried on. When you die, what will speak for you as a father and as a mother?
Na se owu ase eja ni enna no e den e be ka samo ke no owu ye no e sa ne niama pa nte no enne ne niama pa e da so e ka sama no.
Abel dead yet still speaks. Dead yet still speaks. Father, mother, what is going to speak for you? What legacy will the children leave and practice?
Say awofuano, say yewa, e woja diemen yedi jayema. A omonsuno umeti mi e jinasu edi aye juma.
I rest my case. Dead still speaks. May your legacy speak for you. May your legacy speak for you. What are the values that will speak for your children? I pray that God will produce great leaders out of us.
Amen.
Let's rise on our feet. What a blessing. What a word. No, I'm not hearing you. What a word.
Wonu kwari mo na minim
small group. Are you a pastor with a small group ministry in a church? Are you looking for ways to make your small groups effective that will lead to church growth? Are you struggling with how to start a small group in your church? Then look no further. Grab a copy of Small Groups Manual by Bishop S.N. Mensah for practical steps in starting small groups and identifying the roles of both leaders and members in keeping a healthy small group. Remember, in the midst of a pandemic where large gatherings are not permitted, the only effective means to keep in touch with your congregation is through the small groups. The small groups are met in homes in the books of Acts were a strategic part of the greater church and hence remains an indispensable element of church management. For copies of this book, contact the following numbers: 0243 277-084 or 054-2599-834. Remember, a pastor without a small group is a pastor without a church.
Relevant, live and socially related messages from Bishop S.N. Mensah.
Let's look at some of the testimonies that we read around the world about the impact of our ministry, the impact of the church, the impact of this word to many lives.
It has been an awesome moment in the presence of the Lord and the messages by Bishop Samuel N. Mensah right here on Transformation Hour keep making resounding impacts. Let's hear a few messages and comments from individuals all across the globe who have been mightily blessed by Transformation Hour. Kwesi Ank is very excited about the messages by Bishop Samuel N. Mensah and he says, I'm not religious, but I love the messages of this pastor. If all pastors will speak the truth like this, their sheep and members will awaken. Joe Success, who has been mightily touched by the message, says, this message got my heart. I keep asking myself these questions over and over again. This is because our leaders are not preparing us for the next 20 years. Rather, they are preparing for what they can achieve for themselves. Should we say our leaders are selfish? Well, Mundanya Kango also shares his thoughts and he says, Africans don't have vision for the future. This is because the white man convinced them that there is no heaven and no need to consider this current life. Meanwhile, the same white man is on earth living like the same heaven he told us about. If we don't wake up as Africans, we must know we are not going anywhere. Washington Foley would also like to know where Full Gospel Church International is located. Well, Full Gospel Church International has various branches across the country. Do get in touch with us and we will be glad to have you join us. Will Paris also says, I don't go to church, but because of your teaching, I would like to come to your place. Can someone give me his location, please? Well, Bishop Samuel N. Mensah is located at Full Gospel Church International. Once again, do get in touch with us via our social media platforms or any of the contacts below, and we will be glad to have you join us. Charles Barclays exclaims, wow, what a powerful message. And from Williams Gomba, he says, you are really preparing man in this generation, sir. This is a wonderful message. Another message from Godi Onyewumbu, and he says, my bishop, your preachings are so great that I can't stop listening to you. I look forward to seeing you. We look forward to seeing you as well, Godi. And the last message is from a Muslim who enjoys listening to Bishop Samuel N. Mensah. And he says, Bishop Samuel N. Mensah, I really love you from my heart. This is because any of your preachings give me more strength to fight for what I want in my life. God bless you, Bishop. Well, we would like to get in touch with you once again, so do make sure to get in touch with us via social media platforms or any of the contacts down below. God bless you so much for joining Transformation Hour. Keep on listening to us and ensure that you are transforming lives on purpose.
Thank you for watching, and we hope you've been blessed. We invite you to join us this and every Sunday for our friendly service at the Full Gospel Church International, Community One, behind Ogbonu FM Tema, or at any of our branches across the country. For more inquiries, prayers, and counseling, contact us on the following numbers: 0242-774-308, 0244-973-326, 0244-489-046, 0243-858-207, or 0542-599-834. Visit our website at www.fullgospelghana.org or send us an email at info@fullgospelghana.org. You can write personally to Bishop S.N. Mensah at Bishop Mensah@fullgospelghana.org. Full Gospel Church International, transforming lives on purpose.